Unfortunately, organized religion in the whole is corrupt. We have to face this reality and move to something different and hopefully reacquire the spirit. That's why I wanted to read a little passage here.
Yeah, you were going to do that. Go ahead.
Yes. Most gracious Lord, Master, Messiah, and Savior of humanity, we greet thee with all humility. Thou art the first cause and the last effect, the divine light and the spirit of guidance, Alpha and Omega. Thy light is in all forms, thy love in all beings, in a loving mother, in a kind father, in an innocent child, in a helpful friend, in an inspiring teacher. Allow us to recognize thee in all thy holy names and forms, as Rama, as Krishna, as Shiva, as Buddha. Let us know thee as Abraham, as Solomon, as Zarathustra, as Moses, as Jesus, as Muhammad, and in many other names and forms, known and unknown to the world. Because
and who
the
is
truth
that?
Is...
Go ahead.
Hmm? The truth is that we have to move forward, and these religions are just being used to oppress people and mind control them. We have to go above that.
Yeah, and I asked the question, and if we got a few minutes here, somebody wants to call. We didn't. I'm going to get into this subject in the next couple of weeks, but I've always dealt with the truth about what people bring up about the Protestant Reformation and how it was formed by Martin Luther and how they've been basically at odds with the Vatican ever since, how that's been manipulated now by the Vatican. But the question should be this. Did the Vatican in the beginning create the Protestant Reformation for a reason? And is it the same reason that they create enemies like Al-Qaeda and communism? Is it the same reason? And isn't it a perfect way to always create havoc, and that is to have an create the enemy? So you Protestants out there that have done more research than me, and you, especially those who talk about the Protestant Reformation, can we deal with that question? We've dealt with the question of whether Islam was created by the Vatican, but did the Vatican create the Reformation for a reason? And you have to remember, that was the time of the Council of Trent. It was the time the Jesuits were just formed. And I wouldn't put anything past them. Wouldn't put you, Leo?
You
know, it's a thought. Because if you have the enemy, then you can always control the enemy and always get your way and keep your power. So let's talk about that someday, and I'd love to read more about that. And maybe there's people out listening that can comment on that question. But it's a valid one, because we here in America should deal with that question, just as Muslims should deal with the question of whether their religion has been infiltrated. According to Alberto Rivera. Now, there's been stories either way on that. Now, also, you Jews out there, what about Judaism in the Vatican? I mean, they've created you as an enemy. They've taken over your, according to many, including Barry Chamish, they've taken over the Israeli government. Then they put people, you know, it's very interesting that then they'll put people with Jewish names in positions of high power in America, and then all you hear on the internet is people screaming that the Jews are the problem, the Zionists are the problem, the American Free Press, and their line of propaganda, along with many radio stations, all you hear. And don't you ever think that they put those guys there for a reason? And they're actually what I call Pope Court Jews? And that's a great way to take away the real heat off the enemy, the real enemy, and that's blame somebody else, and then in your way, what do you get? You get to kill the Jews, you get to kill the Muslims, you get to kill the Christians that you don't like, and guess who's left? The Satanists, right, Leo?
Yeah, well, they always seem to prevail at the end in some twisted way.
Look at it that way, so start researching if you're a Jew, research really what's going on. If you're a Christian, do the same. Step out of the Bible, step out of the Quran, out of the religious books, and step into the geopolitical world and see what the hell is going on. And then, because I think the prophet, I mean, even Jesus, when Jesus was here on earth, he was very much concerned about the Pharisees and the Sadducees and what was going on in the political world. And what's changed today? What, do we just let these guys like Clinton and Bush and the leaders of Italy and Israel get away with hiding behind what they Bush calls himself, a Bible-believing Christian, I believe. I mean,
it's very interesting. It's very interesting, actually, going back to the Gulen movement, that Hillary Clinton went to a yearly gathering. They guested her, and she promised to go back also this year. So, you see, all these people are all connected and working together.
All right, I got a question here on an email from Henry again. He says, tell Leo he has many supporters here, and we want to stay in touch. Ask him about Obama, McCain, Clinton. He wrote Obama is a Mason. Elaborate. Is that something you wrote about?
Yes, I wrote about in the middle of February about it. The 13th, I published an article in various sites. And just confirming that Obama is an important CFR member, that he has also a very important role in the Council of Foreign Relations. And in the Freemasons, he's a 32-degree Freemason. Apparently, he has been raised now to 33rd. This is Prince of Freemasonry, which is not all recognized by the United Kingdom of England, but in the last few years, it's starting to be recognized and going back under the control of the Duke of Kent and the Queen of England, that function as trade union with the Vatican.
Yeah, and if anybody wants to read more about McCain, go to my website.
The connection with the Vatican and the CFR has also been discussed in the past by people like Harry John Phelps, so it's quite clear where Obama is coming from. Hillary Clinton comes from the same environment. She's also CFR. And so it's just a game that's going to see either one or the other stepping down as vice president. That's how it is.
Yeah, my money is on, if I'm a betting man, I'm betting on Hillary Clinton, next president. Obama will be her vice president. And the reason I state that is I was interviewed a FBI agent who knew Clinton very well when he was governor, and he made a boastful statement when all the Arkansas boys were sitting around the governor's mansion, and he told this guy that he said, listen, boys, I'm going to tell you right now, I'm going to be the president, my wife's going to be the president, and I'm going to head up the U.N., and I'll tell you, I'm putting my money on Hillary based on that statement. And Obama as a running mate. And just recently, Bush made some comment that he even feels the Democrat could win this election. So I think it's going to be Clinton again, Obama as a running mate. And, boy, what a group. I mean, ask Hillary Clinton about her connection to her following of a Jesuit priest by the name of Pierre de Chardin, who headed up the New Age movement in America. Very interesting story. And there's a gentleman wants to file a lawsuit under the Logan Act to register all Jesuits in this country as foreign agents working for a foreign potentate, that being someone detrimental to the United States government, and that's the Pope. So that'd be interesting under the Logan Act. But, Leo, you know, we only have a couple minutes. Give us step by step what if people want to get in touch with you or help you in any way, how they can do that.
Well, they can call me, as I said before. It's probably the only way they can contact me because I don't have an email at the moment.
Give out your number real quick.
The number is 0047-9010-8914.
All right, we're all out of time, Leo. You keep in touch. Thanks for being on the show, and we'll have you on again.
God bless America, and thank you.